If you're looking for the best camera accessory you can buy, this is the holy grail. Let's get into the video. Hey guys, what's up? My name is Jose, as usual, and today we're talking about my favorite camera accessory of all time, the Spiderlight camera holster. Now, I've never featured it on this channel, but for the past 3 years, in every single shoot I've done, not once have I gone into that session without this thing on me. I'm being serious, over 150 weddings, God knows how many headshot sessions, branding sessions, you know, photo, video, anything, I always have this thing on me. So what is it? Let's talk about it. Now, to start off, the biggest issue that I have when I'm doing weddings or really type of any photography session is that I need to use my hands. I mean, that's just a given, right? As photographers, you need to be able to manipulate your scene, whether that's fluffing out a bride's dress, moving a C-stand, or really just having your hands open so you can interact with your subject and explain exactly what you need them to do. So this is where the Spiderlight camera holster comes in. This is a two-part system where it has the holster and it has the camera plate. So what happens is this will sit on your pants or on your belt. And what you do is you literally just drop it in and you're good to go. It's amazing. So the plate on the camera part is pretty discreet. It's out of the way and it has a little knob that slots into the receiver part to allow your camera to sit nice and snug. And what's even better is as you kind of lock that in there, I mean, it stays locked. I mean, this thing isn't going anywhere. I've hung my FX3 rig from it. Of course, I've hung my A7 IV on it, but it doesn't move anywhere until you disengage the lock. Once you pull the lock up, it's free to go, super quick and easy to use. And in my opinion, if you're looking for something that helps you quickly stow and dry your camera, this little gadget is the best thing on the market. Now, obviously, if we're talking about things to help us put away our camera for a bit, we have to talk about camera straps. Now, camera straps are great. They're fun and they feel nice, but here's my big issue with them is that they move around too much. They move your camera around too much. So when I'm doing something like turn around, my camera will swing around with me. If I'm doing something like trying to go through a crowd, same thing, it's gonna lead behind me. And another issue that I have with camera straps is that depending on their length, when you bend down to pick something up, or like I mentioned earlier, like fluff bride's dress or move your equipment around, you run the risk of your camera hitting the ground. Now, you can fix this by shortening the length of the strap, but then you run into another issue, is that the shorter your strap gets, it's more difficult to handle your camera and manipulate it because it's too tight up against your body. It can be a little bit uncomfortable. So there is really no middle ground, and so that's why I don't really love straps for wedding photography. And you might be like, oh, this guy doesn't know what he's talking about. Like, no, really, I've tried every camera strap and configuration and size and equipment. And I really do think that the Spiderlight holster is the way to go. Like, out of everything I've tried over the past 3-4 years, that really is my go-to. And so we're talking about devices to kind of help put your camera away for a little bit. We have to talk about the Peak Design Clip. Now, the Peak Design Clip is great. I think it's an amazing product and I love what they did with this. But in my opinion, the Peak Design Clip is really more geared for not wedding activity, for not photo shoots. It's more for if you're traveling and you want a camera with you, that tends to be a little bit bigger. This is great. You can put this on a backpack. You can maybe put this on a belt. I've done it a few times and it's not my most comfortable experience. But the Peak Design Clip is more for someone who isn't actively stowing or drawing their camera as often as, you know, someone as a wedding photographer. Another issue with this is that the Peak Design Clip has a manual engage and disengage knob. So when it's locked away, that camera's staying on there and it's not gonna be able to get unlocked. But if I wanna get the camera out of the Peak Design Clip, I need to manually turn the lock and then press the button. So that adds an extra action that I really don't wanna mess with. On top of that, when it's disengaged, it's kind of easy to press this button. Now, I've never dropped my camera on this thing. I did use it for a few months, but it's something that I would constantly feel that slightly bump into it and I would risk dropping my camera. While the Spiderlight holster, however, it's pretty drop in and play. As soon as you drop that in, it stays locked. You don't need to like disengage or engage a lock or whatever. It's gonna stay there. And then whenever you do need your camera, you can manually move that lock and you're good to go. And like I mentioned before, with in terms of camera straps and all that stuff swinging around, because this holster strap goes right up against your body, you don't have to worry about it swinging wide because the contact point is right up against you. The clip is also super discreet. It's small, it's lightweight, but it's also super durable. And in terms of the plate, because we're thinking about, oh, is this compatible with my camera? Absolutely it is. The plate will fit on any camera that has a 1/4-inch thread that you can mount tripods on. So that's almost every professional camera on the market, if not all of them, have that attachment point. And so you just put that right on there and then boom, the system is ready to go. And honestly, I mean, this thing, like I mentioned, discreet, it's really, really discreet. So I love wearing suits for weddings and I'm walking about 12, 14 hours a day sometimes. And I forget that I have this thing on. By this point, this has become a second nature item to me. I've had times where I've done a full day of wedding and I don't realize I still have this on until I'm on the car ride back. But even still, oh, okay, cool. I just take it out and I stick it in my pocket. Bam, good to go. And if I can't say enough praise about this product, the plate is also Arca Swiss compatible, meaning that it fits on all my tripods, including my Peak Design tripod that I'm using for this video. I'm all about using Arca Swiss for all the stuff that I do. I think it's a great system. It's cheaper than Manfrotto. And so this just adds on to it. It's amazing, seriously. In terms of weight limit, as far as I know, there isn't any, but for bigger wedding days where I'm also running my FX3 rig alongside my Sony a7 IV for photo and video for Instagram reels, I do also use the Holdfast Moneymakers, the harness. And so what I do is, because this thing also has another 1/4-inch under it, so you can still put a manual tripod on it, you can just put the Peak Design harness on there and it's super quick and it feels safer. But more so is it takes a little bit of the weight off of my waist and lower back. But then, okay, then why not just run the Moneymakers and then call it a day? I mean, this fits two cameras. Well, here's the thing is, just like the camera straps that we were talking about earlier, these things do swing out. Now, the contact points tend to be a lot smaller. The length on the straps are a lot shorter, but they still do swing around. So I like having this more as of a redundancy or to give me an option to be even quicker. Instead of having to worry about putting my FX3 down in the little clip, I can just let it go and then I'm good. But if I want to really keep everything secure, I will still lock it down in the Spiderlight clips. And if I'm running just one camera, then I'll ditch the camera holster harness thing altogether and I'll just run the Spiderlight clip. And so I talk about how it's nice to have your hands ready for, you know, moving things around, whether it's furniture or getting this person there, whatever. But in my opinion, the biggest reason why I love this thing outside of weddings is because it lets me connect with my model, with my subject. I think when there's a big camera in the way and you're like, hey, can you do that and this and that? It gets in the way. It's jarring. Look how massive this freaking thing is. And so by putting this away, you can just go, hey, how's it going? I hope you're doing well. Boo, boo, boo. That's locked in. Like, that's safe. So I can just talk with the person I need to, and then I can unclip and I'm good to go. Now, we do have to talk about a small issue, a super duper teeny tiny issue that I have with this product, which is more towards the company. The company that manufactures this, Spider Holsters, has a lot of different holsters and types and whatever. For example, they have the Spiderlight holster, which is what I bought 3 years ago. It's still kicking, it's still going strong. It doesn't feel like it's gonna break ever. And it's great, it's incredible. But then they also have the Spider Pro, which seems like it's the exact same thing as the Spiderlight, but it has two little hooks at the end of it that I don't think do anything. They're just for decoration purposes. And it also just has a name change. Like, that's it. But the material is the same. So yeah. And the Spider Pro is not to be confused with the Spider Pro dual camera system, which is really just the Spider Pro or Spiderlight mounted on a belt. Now, to be fair, the dual camera system with the Spider Pro is a great option, especially for female photographers. You know, a lot of people don't have pants, they don't have a belt, they don't have places where they can loop that in there. And so for people wearing a dress or a romper, this is a great option, having that Pro system to have a belt that will just stick on you and let you have a dual camera system. You can also buy just the individual side, but I mean, if you're there, might as well buy both sides and just call it a day. But on top of that, they also have the Spider X, which is literally the exact same thing as the Spiderlight, except it's made of cheap plastic. And when I say cheap, I literally mean cheap. The lock, like it's locked right now, it's real sticky and it's uncomfortable. It doesn't feel like that good of quality. And I freaking hate this thing. I bought it on mistake. I thought I was getting another Spiderlight, but I definitely was not. So yeah, don't buy this thing. It feels like a piece of junk. My biggest issue is that the lock always engages on open and it stays open. So if I'm not careful, the camera can fall out of the Spider X, but not on the Spider Lite, which is the same thing as the Spider Pro. You get what I mean. And then I don't have one, but the Spider Holster Black Widow is kind of the same system, except it's cheaper plastic and it's really made for more lighter cameras. I've never tried it. I don't recommend it because in my opinion, this does everything. And they have more holsters, but you get the point. In terms of mounting options, because remember, it's a two-part system. So you have this, the holsters part, and then you have the plates. Now the plates, they have mirrorless setups, which is what I have here. They have a DSLR plate. They have a lens collar plate. They have a plate that mounts on L brackets with a clamp. They have different options. But here's where I start running into issues is when you have all those things, most, if not all of them, seem unnecessary. In my opinion, you just really need the mirrorless plate. Now, I say that as a mirrorless guy is like, oh, I don't understand DSLR struggles, but it fits everything. Like, I've had it on a DSLR. I've had it on a small film camera. I run it on my FX3 rig that hopefully I am showing footage of. I hope it's rolling right now. Huzzah! Cool. Like, I run it on everything. So I don't see why these other products exist. I get maybe if they were developing it and they're still just being manufactured, but in my opinion, the Spiderlight holster and the mirrorless plate are the way to go. And so that's great. Now we know, oh, that's the Spider X. Now we know, like, oh, buy the Spiderlight holster. Great. Here's the issue is the Spiderlight is not even sold on their website anymore. It's sold on Amazon, but it seems that the page for this is unlisted. It's still on Amazon. But you can't find it through the search engine. You have to get a direct link to buy this product. Now, if you don't believe me, go to Amazon, go try out a Spiderlight holster, any variation of that on the search engine and see if you can find it, because I couldn't. But the link is down in the description. I'm gonna leave it down there. I'm not gonna make any money off that link. That's straight copy and paste from Amazon. And so you can consider buying one of these products. They can be a little bit expensive, but we'll talk more about that later. But that link in the description will get you straight to the buying page, which from my research is the only place I've been able to find to buy the Spiderlight holster. Now, you can just buy the Spider Pro, which is the same thing. But I mean, this is what I use. This is what I've used for 3-4 years. And this is the only thing I can vouch for in my opinion. And now, while I mentioned the mirrorless plate has been great, I'll be honest with you, over 3 years and taking it on and off, the little rubber kind of friction pads that are under it to kind of connect with the camera have fallen off on my older model. So that's a little bit frustrating, but I mean, it's still going strong. It's nothing Loctite can't fix. And if I just make sure everything's tight, the plate's not gonna come off. Now, I would have liked that the newer plates have the little side metal thing to help you unscrew it a little easier. And it's also frustrating because the newer plates don't use, as far as I know, the standard a standard metric hex key. They use an Imperial or something custom, so it's a little frustrating sometimes to get a hex tool measurement to take the plate off. But like I mentioned, these things barely come off my camera anyways, so it's fine. Like, I don't really care. And in my opinion, for using this almost every weekend, multiple times a week for 3 years, it's still alive and kicking with no issues. Yeah, I'm all about it. And so now we have to talk about price. What are these things gonna run you? So this is from my experience. Now the price might change later on down the line, but I paid $130 for it. Now that seems like a lot for a piece of metal that just sits on your camera. But over 3 years, I would have gladly paid that 3-4 times over. I mean, I've tried buying a second one. It just happened to be the wrong holster. But really, like, the thing is amazing. And it comes with the plate and it comes with the holster, and it might last you for the rest of your life. And so in my opinion, buy once, cry once, but get things that will allow you to expand your expertise and to make your life easier. This is an investment to yourself. In my opinion, this really is worth the money. So in my opinion, can I recommend the Spiderlight holster? Yes, 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 100 times over. In my opinion, this single tool has helped me grow incredibly as a professional, and it's helped me advance my business. And if you're still on the fence about buying this product, I'm not sponsored, like, at all. They did not. Spider Holster did not pay me to do this. They don't even know I'm making this video. I generally just believe in this product so much, and I'm grateful that it exists enough that I'm gonna spend time editing this video and recording it and posting it. Like, I don't make any money if you go buy this thing or not. Like, I really don't care. I'm just trying to help you guys find the tools that will help you become a better photographer, and this is definitely one of them. And that's gonna be it for the video. Look, if you guys have any more questions, feel free to let me know in the comment section down below. I love chatting with you guys. I like interacting and figuring stuff out. If you liked the video, then consider liking the video. And if you feel like subscribing, then go for it so I can show my mom that people actually watch me. Outside of that, have a good rest of your day. Thank you all very much for watching, and I'll see you on the next one. Peace.